Everyone, it's Dave, Display Fireworks Line. I'm here at Bobby Kellner's. Open shoot today. I'm gonna give you a little tour of the warehouse. Now at the open shoot, you can shoot anything here that you bought, and you can shoot 1-3 product. I've actually helped, and I just met a guy here from Ohio. Many people get their ATF license just to come here to shoot. You can get a license. All right, I'm seeing some new product here Bobby has. Let's see here, Magnus. This is like the house brand floating. Oh, that's off the light. That's like the house brand floating around. Oh, it spins, I get it, everywhere. Now, I'll give you an idea of the price here. Let me make sure I get this right. This is the case price. Probably not good to show on Fountain. Here, 36 of these cones would be $47. Now tonight, if you would probably run 36 into here, it's probably $1.50 a cone, I'm gonna guess. Tonight this is if you would buy just one, it's $3. But tonight you get 50% off of that price, if I remember these calculations right. Now it starts here with the Safe and Sane product. And then it moves. Okay, here we have some. This is new in Pennsylvania. We could buy anything. Well, I always could buy anything, but a regular consumer can come in here in Pennsylvania and buy anything. Here's bottle rockets. Like these. This is case price. You see how many. If you bought just one tonight, like normally this would be $6.50, but tonight it's half of that. So you get the case price, if I'm explaining this right. So it's a special deal for tonight only. Normally when you buy one piece, and I'm gonna have to, I didn't do the calculations, but I'm sure it's the same as it's been in previous years. The single price is twice the case price. Plus he has additional discounts, depending on what customer level you are. Bottle rock. I'm not a big fan of bottle rockets, I'm going to be honest with you. Maybe one's a good boom, but just the color and that kind of stuff, I'm not too big on it. Only the good ones. Give you an idea of some more prices. Just buy what you need. See what kind of candles we got this year. 10 ball. You can really get creative with these candles if you don't have a lot of money. I mean, you get the whole case, you know, $63, put something together. That's what I used to do years ago. I'm really not familiar with any of this, some of this product here. Let's see. That's what I say, mag value. Here's the prices. Okay, here's probably more fountains. I want a big damn cone fountain. I had some, but they're kind of all disappeared. Used to be a big gray fountain out. Really, really nice. I love those things. They're just tough to come by. That's the open shoot. People shooting 1-3 stuff. I should probably get some of these sparklers, I think. I think they ran out. I never understood the purpose of these big stick ones because they're not all that much bigger, you know what I mean? It's like maybe twice the size. These are good sometimes to get rid of rodents. Some of these fireworks products, you can light it and just stick it in a hole and cover it up with your foot. It'll smoke them out. Oh, let's see, firecracker. Let's see. Bombs. They're cheap enough, huh? Like, see, tonight, let's see, a case of these, 20 packs of 100. Man, it couldn't be this one, is it? Could be that cheap. Yeah, wait. I had to stop for a minute. Somebody wants to talk to me.
But no, I don't do that.
Okay, we're back. I hope it shows up. I'm going around with a tour, and somebody ran into me, Bill, here.
Hi, on the forums, I saw Dave, and I had to interrupt your video. Sorry, folks.
Yeah, let me see. We'll see. This is, turn it this way. Oh, there you go. That's how often I do it. I rarely use it.
There you go.
There we go. Now we can see each other. Bill is, you're learned a lot, he said, from watching my videos
and reading other posts on the forum. And yeah,
there you go. My website's pyrotalk.com. Well, anyway, buddy, thanks for running into me. I gotta finish this tour and get out there and see what's going on. This cover, that's a pretty box, huh? This comes in Celebration and Firecrackers. I don't see the price on there. Oh, here it is, $78. I used to always, like back years ago, I would say, you could tell the whole price structure of a store by the price of this item right here. This is the one item to compare that usually tells you the whole price structure of the whole store as a consumer. That's a comparable item that usually everyone has, and there's not much variation in it. You can't get good firecrackers. It's tough. Okay, what do we have here? Oh, more Roman candles. Oh, these are parachute candles. Yeah, that's kind of, that's something different and fun. Let's see, 18 packs of four. Tonight, that would be $6. It's a good deal, I think. You don't see much of these. You know, years back, I used to use these. Now, if you're pretty talented and you know, limited budget, you could set this kind of thing up out on sticks. And if you have a firing system, fuse it up, let it spin around, this sort of thing. You could burn your driveway up with these ground blooms. Let's see what's on. For people that can't make a decision, just grab a whole kit right here. A little mix of everything. This looks like the old Pennsylvania kind of thing. Oh no, Bambino crackers. Alright, let's see what the artillery shells are all about this year. Let's see. This was always a favorite over the years here. The bombastics. Now, these may be the newer ones. See, this is the new design on the top of the shell to hopefully keep people from putting it in backwards. You know, if that will happen or not, who knows. But it's always an issue. You think it's obvious, but people still put these things in backwards. See, whistling. Let's see. Something new this year. Is it? Yeah, it's some sort of a canister shell. Although these feel like a little heavier product, to be honest. No, this is heavy. What's this one? I don't see the price. Neon canister shell. Nice. Ball shells. Race day. This one's been around. Let's see. What's this little one shot? Little one shot ball shell. Okay, here's your mortars for you guys that like to build. Fiberglass, HDPE right here. I'm sure he has the complete racks also here somewhere. Plenty of fuse. Somebody got something going out there. Okay. Oh, what's this? Something new. Oh, this is the Articles of Pyro. Now this is for you people advanced into, what's this, gerb, always like that term, gerb, he's a gerb. This is if you have a firing system and you want to get a little more into things. Paramusicals, this sort of thing. Now we're going back into this Boss system. Still around. Lance pieces. Some more gerbs. Now, you know, every person that sells these has a different qualification. Now, ATF license, they'll just sell it to you. If you have a shooter certificate of some sort, he'll sell it to you. I came up with something on my website. Kellner's isn't necessarily on that list, but I have three companies that will accept it. So you need some level of something above being just a consumer. You know, with mine, you know, I have to prove you have a firing system, certain firing system, that makes you more of an advanced enthusiast. That's kind of what there is. Some more article stuff, it looks like. Yeah, some of this stuff's pretty good. Let's see. Let's see, just look at some of these prices. This is a good kick. Now, I don't know if you ever saw some of my old Sportsman's Club videos. Someone brought a couple of these. And back when I was able to, you know, bring just about anyone in to shoot. And man, that is a nice kick right there. A true blue Blitz. You get two pieces for that price. More Magnus. I don't know much about it, but as it's out there, we'll see some more about it. Stone to the bone. So, for example, tonight this would be half of that, $33. Let's see what we got here. Showing you an example, Desert Rose. Take a look at some of the pricing. So you get four pieces for that price of whatever this is. 500 gram cake. That's kind of it right here. And we're coming to the end. Right here. Alright. So that's basically a look at the warehouse. Here's a little shot of the parking lot tonight for the open shoot. The turnout is not as big as it's been over the years. I don't know whether a lot of people got scared of the rain or whatever it is, but it's normally how this goes. Is the no one's shooting any consumer stuff, but the B stuff or 1-3 stuff is usually down here. And there's usually like racks set up. Occasionally someone will shoot a shell up. But maybe they're waiting until it gets dark, I don't know. But you can see the parking lot's wet. And it did rain. So here's some of the magazines right here. If you're new to my videos. It's basically a trailer. And you put a skirt around it. One there. One back here. This kind of works its way down. And I think he has some up this way too. And this is his consumer product warehouse. So this is where we're at. But there's people that'll come here at these open shoots here. Fire or different places. No matter what state you're from, you can come here and get an ATF license based on just wanting to come here one day to shoot. I've done it. And once you're licensed for the whole period. As it gets dark, maybe it'll pick up. Hey, I ran into someone to help get ATF license here in the parking lot. Here's a firing system. I don't know if you remember this guy. I made fun of him. I said, he had his own firing system. I said, some people do anything save $100. He goes, hey, I finally broke down and bought one. Here it is right here. This is actually one of the better ones, and I'm going to tell you why. Yeah. All right, here. Let's show them what you could do here.
There, one's going there.
Yeah.
It's like up 2, 3, four.
All right, now you could do something fancy with it.
There's all fire.
Yeah.
And here's sequence. Steps through.
Okay. Now here's what makes this one. I'm gonna shut it off because that light's kind of. This is what makes this one of the better ones. See those little holes right there? You can program this. You stick a little paper clip in there, and you can program these buttons. Although he doesn't have to because he could do an all fire, but you could make it that if you press one button, two of these fire, or do all kinds of. I never knew that.
I've got three modules, so if I wanted to do three one, set them all to one, spread them out, one.
So you could program all of them to this,
or as many as you get.
You can do 50 of them, right? Yeah. So there is some advantage to these. There's no doubt. Takes what is it, four
double A's?
Yeah, four double A's.
And then this one takes, I forget what the one.
That's
a strange battery.
Yeah, it's I can't think of it. I got a single 12 volt battery.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I get it out of there.
But here it is right here. See, this one's different than the ones I'm used to. The one I know has a button on the side, but now some of the other ones have one single program button in the middle, but this one has, you could do each cue. So it's a little better one.
Well, I've got another set in. I got a couple different ones.
Boy, you really broke down.
One only cost me $30. All right. I got this little one shot guy.
It
doesn't have much of a range on it.
See, he got all kind. Now, he broke down. He bought all kind of stuff. All right, now here's what I'm going to show you. let's see, get it in focus. See how that has one single program button right above that green thing? And none in the back. Now this one, see, there's four program buttons and none here. Now, you got to watch these remotes. You're saying you can't make this
looks,
do that.
No, it looks the same, but the buttons to get to do the all fire is a little different.
I mean, will it fire single?
It'll still fire single. It works like...
I mean,
like
single here and here? Your phone?
I don't think so.
You'd have to program it.
I don't think they will talk to each other. Let's just try 9 and see if it does anything.
You know what I'm talking about when I say to program it.
Yeah.
You stick a paper clip in.
Yeah, right. That's why I got
it. Yeah, and then you hold it. Okay, yeah, you know how to do it. Yeah. Okay.
But I can't get these.
It's probably a different.
This won't work with that. Different frequency, probably.
Yeah, it could be. Different. Over the years, they may have changed it. Now, I know some that have that little tiny remote. I think you had it up here. Let's see. Now, that one, I don't think will work at all with these.
It even has the hertz on the back of this one.
Yeah.
433.
I'll be honest with you, I don't really like these.
They don't have much range.
Yeah, it's more like for like right here to here.
Yeah, it's real.
But they like to give these to you because
you can almost
cheap,
light
right?
it. You can almost light it with, with a long match.
Where's the mod for that? Let me see. Yeah, that's you know what? I had a kit like this. Now you could program this too. See the little hole right here? Yeah, you can put a little paper clip in that little hole. And it'll program it in program mode. So I don't know if it'll work. You could try to program it.
Oh, okay.
Or just use it. Yeah, it's good for a little single.
Mm-hmm.
You only want to bring it out. So there's a purpose for these.
I use that when I'm doing a landscape.
Yeah. Oh, you got some. What size are those?
Those are 3/4. These are the ones I was shooting before, the 2-inch salutes.
Two-inch salutes.
Yeah, mine Comet Break.
Yeah, what is this? Cardboard.
Yeah. But then here, there's the racks. I built these racks.
Are those 2-inch salutes really 2-inch? Are they canister or just round?
They're preloaded.
Kellner sells this. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is nice. Nice little, what's this, canister shells?
Yeah, this one's an actual 2-inch gun. I don't have any 2-inch shells, though.
Yeah, great. So you're making progress.
Try it.
You're getting there. Yeah, you're getting there. Now your next move after this, you'll be going into the Cobra one day.
I know.
I can see it coming.
I haven't justified. Every
but
year
I'll be
I say
honest,
I'm going
you,
to.
You can get a lot done with this. You really can.
I can't. Yeah, I can't really justify getting it right now.
That's all right.
But I know one day I'm going to do it. I tried doing a pyro musical this year just with music and me being in the queue.
How'd it turn out?
The guy doing the music screwed up.
This is what you get.
And then I got screwed up, and then I just started hitting buttons.
This is what you get with free help. All right, what else you got in the bag? I feel like a cop. I want to look at all this shit. Right? What you got in the bag here?
That's just all wires and stuff.
Oh yeah, what you got? Match.
Yeah, okay. Oh, no, matches. Are, I got talons. I got the.
Yeah, yeah.
I got the.
Got the MJGs.
Yeah.
Okay, you looking good. Yeah. You're making progress. All right, my man, good job. Talking to my man here, and he has an issue. He says that he's trying to light artillery shells with this quick match. And here's the problem right here. He's saying, I put the fuse in there, and he slits it with a knife, and he puts his little viscos in there, trying to light like 4 of these at one time. I said, tear it open, let's look. I don't know if you can see it. It's that gray damn quick match. It's bad. I don't like it. I don't know why they ever made this stuff, but that's why. It lights so fast and violent that it's good if you want to go from like here to here, like to send the fire over maybe to a display shell. But if you're trying to get product lit with this, particularly going from the quick match into the visco, you can forget it. This stuff is just, you may get some to light and some won't. But I said, that's your problem right here, is that it's a gray perchlorate stuff. I don't like it. I don't know, and you can usually tell it's wrapped red, it's wrapped blue. And it's cheap, and it's just no good for our purpose as backyard guys. Now, if you probably had, making shells where you light it and send the fire down, it would work. But you set this out and light it, it's violent. I've actually taken it and put a bunch of that in the shell. You make a damn firecracker out of it. It's that powerful that it'll light. That's your problem right there.
Okay.
So the next time you buy, look at it. If it's gray, my advice is don't buy it. And here's what the Chinese are doing now. And they may have even done it with this one. They start to put charcoal in it to hide that it's gray. But that's not traditional black match right there. It's gray. Alright, that's the problem. Just want to tell you. Okay, now here's another fuse I want to show you. Yeah. This looks actually like the Mexican fuse. Mexican quick match. Years ago, American quick match used to look like this. It would be real thick. Only it did. This paper here looks like that quick match out of Mexico. But that is black powder quick match. Actually, that thread's too damn big the more I think about it. But
that's just one strand.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, it's too thick. But it's I'll be honest with you, if you were gonna light those shells, I would use this. Mm-hmm. If you got a bunch of this,
yeah,
get rid of this stuff, this red stuff.
Okay.
Use this, get a razor blade, slice into it. Put your visco fuse from your canister shell in there and tape it. This will have its own oxygen, it won't go out. And then put your electric match in the end of this, or however you want to light it, and I guarantee you it'll light those shells. Send them up.
Yeah, I'll try that.
You got more of this? This is good.
Yes, somewhere.
Yeah, this, I don't know what to tell you, but use it for like sending fire in one direction.
Yeah.
And even then, if you try to light visco at the end of it, it may just blow right past it. Anyway, this is a good find right here. It'd be nice if we can get some actual American-made quick match from back in the day. Or the Chinese, if they ever watch this video. Get rid of this perchlorate junk. Okay, the game's over. It's no good.
Didn't look silver. I didn't think it was like a glass coated.
This guy wastes up turning the camera off to tell the best stories. Right? He said they used this on the show, and someone, they were lighting it with torches, and it went so violently, the whole damn finale went up in a second, and somehow, here, don't bring it down, but don't touch that damn button. He said it blew the head right off of one of these somehow when it went off.
Yeah.
That's how violent it was. Yeah, this stuff's bad. Bad news, man. You know, it's not good. And I'd like to see what some of the newer stuff looks like, but yeah, that's another story about it. I messed up a whole demo using this until I started seeing videos, I think, from Spain or something. If you hit this with a hammer, it may even go off. That's how sensitive and violent it is. Okay, that's it. Thanks. All right, everyone, I'm going to wrap it up for the night here at Kellner's Open Shoot 2019. Tomorrow, the boys from Cobra are here. I was just talking to them. They're going to do a little seminar about the Cobra system, which is pretty popular. And they're telling me that it's doing well. And the MJG initiators are also pretty popular, too. So it's a well-used product and a reliable product. All right, everyone. See you in the next video.